Hello guys, the topic of today is epigenetic landscape, a model of differentiation and determination. In this video, we will talk about the epigenesis and how the cells work. So cells are the fundamental working units of every human being. These are the cells through which we are working. It are the cells that are the fundamental working units of every human being. All the instructions required to direct their activities contained within the chemical deoxyribonucleic acid, also known as the DNA. All the work which is done by us are because of the chemical deoxyribonucleic acid, which is known as the DNA. DNA from humans is made up of approximately 3 million nucleotide bases. There are four fundamental type of bases that comprise DNA: adenine, cytosine, guanine, and thymine. Commonly abbreviated as A, C, G, and T respectively. Actually, what happened, we all know that the cells are the fundamental units. If I have to be speak in Hindi, I think so you all are comfortable. क्या होता है कि cells हमारी body में working units हैं. अब cells को काम करने के लिए उन्हें order कौन दे रहा है? वो दे रहा cell के अंदर nucleus. Nucleus के अंदर कौन? DNA. अब DNA के DNA कैसे दे रहा है order? वो DNA के अंदर जो bases है, जैसे कि adenine. क्योंकि हम अपनी बात करें, हम eukaryotes हैं, तुम्हारे अंदर क्या होगी? Adenine, cytosine, guanine, and thymine. अगर मैं बात करूँ prokaryotes की, तो उनके अंदर thymine के अंदर जो residue आ जाएगा. तो होगा क्या? जो DNA है, okay, we know that our DNA is double-stranded. Our DNA is double-stranded. इस पे जीन्स लगे हुए हैं, ओके, बेसिस है. तो बेसिस मान लो कि एक प्रॉपर बेस आया, AUG, इसने मिथाइलेशन करी, जैसे कि और भी कुछ बहुत सारे आए, उन्होंने कुछ रोकने का काम किया, किसी ने क्या काम किया. तो डीएनए बेसिस ने एक पर्टिकुलर प्रोटीन सिंथेसाइज किया, और वो प्रोटीन ट्रांसक्रिप्शन मतलब कि जीन्स का बहुत इसका बहुत फ़र्क है. तो डीएनए फ्रॉम ह्यूमंस हमारा बना हुआ है डीएनए न्यूक्लियोटाइड से, 3 मिलियन न्यूक्लियोटाइड से. अभी न्यूक्लियोटाइड क्या होता है? जो न्यूक्लियोटाइड होता है, न्यूक्लियोसाइड्स प्लस फॉस्फेट, और न्यूक्लियोसाइड के अंदर आता है हमारा बेसिकली डीऑक्सीराइब शुगर, और साथ में बेस आ जाएगी. तो बेसिस हमने देख लिए, हम लोग को AGTC भी बुलाते हैं. तो सिक्वेंस और द ऑर्डर ऑफ द बेसिस, जो सिक्वेंस है और द ऑर्डर है किसकी? बेसिस की, इज व्हाट डिटरमाइंस आवर लाइफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस. द सिक्वेंस और द ऑर्डर ऑफ द बेसिस, एक्चुअली इन विच सिक्वेंस द बेस डेटा एडेनिन, थायमिन, गुआनिन एंड साइटोसिन आर अरेंज्ड, डिटरमाइन आवर लाइफ इंस्ट्रक्शन, विच टाइप ऑफ प्रोटीन आर सिंथेसाइज एंड विच have to be synthesized. Interestingly enough, our DNA sequence is in all human beings, in all species, 99% similar. Only 1%, or we can say that the 15 million bases have a distinctly different sequence that make us human. Our 99% DNA same as chimpanzee. So genes are growing sequence of bases that provide. So what are genes? Genes are the specific sequence of bases, like a specific sequence of bases, like you have to be consider that is a specific sequence of bases that provide instruction to make proteins, complex molecules. This actually what happened, firstly genes make specific particular gene make particular protein, and that particular protein synthesize our biological action that carry out life functions. What is genetics? It is a branch of biology concerned with the study of the genes, genetic variation, and heredity in the organisms. So what is epigenetics? We know that the genetics means study of genes, genetic variation, and heredity. Epi matlab on the above, on the top of genetics. Or we can read it on the top of genetics. It means which control genetics, which control our DNA, it refers to external modification to our DNA that turns DNA on or off. Epigenetic means above, on top of genetics. It refers to the external modification to DNA that turn genes on or off. So epigenetics, what is epigenetics? It refers to external modification of DNA that turn genes on or off. This modification do not change in DNA sequence. Actually, it does not, epigenetic does not mean that it changed the, like our DNA sequence ko change kar dega, aisa nahi hai. It only affect the how the cells read genes and how it make proteins. Matlab in short, it affect the protein synthesis and other things. So epigenetics Laterally means above or on top of genetics. It refers to the external modification to DNA that turn genes on or off. This modification do not change the DNA sequence, but instead they affect how cells read genes. It modification change the DNA sequence and affect how cells read genes. The term epigenetics refers to heritable changes in gene expression. What is the meaning of epigenetics? Epigenetics meaning is refers to heritable changes in gene expression. And what are heritable changes which we acquired? Actually, heritable changes, you have to be read about heritable changes. Actually, heritable genetics is epigenetics refers to heritable changes, meaning the heritable matlab the changes which are non-lethal but pass from one parents to other generation, one generation to other generation. Actually, heritable changes in gene expression that do not change in the DNA sequence but change in phenotype without changing in genotype. Example, what we have to be take a dead gene, their genotype is not changed but phenotype is changed. The study of changes in organism caused by modification of gene expression. Actually, epigenetics does not cause change in DNA sequence. It causes the change in expression of genes. It causes the change in expression of genes. The study of changes in organism caused by modification of gene expression rather than alteration of genetic code itself, that is epigenetics. Epigenetics does not cause to be changed the genetic code, but so I think so you consider the meaning of epigenetics. Actually, it changed the expression of genes, that is epigenetics. So the term epigenetics was first coined by the Conrad H. Farrington in 1942, was derived from the Greek word epigenesis, which originally described the influence of genetic process on development. Actually, the term epigenetics was given by the Conrad H. Farrington in 1942, who gave that the epigenesis meaning. What is the meaning of epigenesis? Epigenesis is above genetic, external genetic, which does not change the genetic code, but is change the expression of that code. So, Conrad S. Farrington and Ernest Haitor started the study of epigenetics. So what is epigenetics? Epigenetics change is a regular and natural occurrence but can also be influenced by several factors like age, environment, lifestyle and disease state. Meaning epigenetics is a natural process but we can control our epigenetic, and the influence of epigenetics is one's age, one's lifestyle, one's environment style, when lifestyle and the disease state, how is in the is disease free or having a disease, it's also affect the epigenetic or epigenesis. Epigenetic change can have more damaging effect that can result in disease like cancer. At least four symptoms including the four symptoms that is including is because of epigenetic. Epigenetic matlab that change the expression of genes, and how the expression of gene changes because of DNA methylation. DNA methylation meaning methyl, what is methyl? Methyl is CH3 group, and the addition of CH3 group is on the DNA on the cytosine chain, and on what, on the fifth carbon of cytosine chain, methyl group is added and formation of methyl CG complex that is altered the DNA sequence, and the chromatin remodeling, histone modification and non-coding RNA associated gene. And what are silencing? Are currently considered to initiate and sustain epigenetic change. And now silencing is also considered to initiate and sustain epigenetic change. The field of epigenetics is quietly growing field. Actually, the field of epigenetics is quickly growing. And with it, the understanding that both the environment and individual lifestyle can also interact with genome to influence epigenetic change. What happens actually with our gene? With our gene, mainly our gene control for any protein formation, and the environment factor and our lifestyle factor control epigenetics and express and alter the expression of the gene. Means epigenetic is being
influenced by environment and our lifestyle. You can see cells can follow the different pathway for differentiation. Different signals are required for the cell differentiation, and different genes are required for signaling of the cell, because signaling molecules are the protein molecules. If DNA expression, gene expression are changed, then different proteins are made and the cells can follow different pathway for differentiation. So epigenetic landscape of somatic cells. Conrad Whittington proposed that pluripotent stem cell differentiate into somatic cell. It is known that the pluripotent stem cells undergo stepwise differentiation, blue arrows producing linear specific progenitor cells that cone to further differentiate into germ layer specific progenitor cells. These layer specific progenitor cells then produce compromised germ layer cells of the endoderm, mesoderm and ectoderm. And now the different epigenetic changes that affect gene expression and therefore cellular function. What are these different epigenetic changes? These different epigenetic changes are DNA methylation, addition of the methyl group on the DNA, chromatin remodeling, histone modification and non-coding RNA. These are the different epigenetic changes that affect expression of DNA and cellular function. Next is epigenetic mechanism are affected by these factors and processes, development in utero and child, environmental chemicals, drugs and pharmaceuticals, aging and diet, addition of the chromatin, addition of the methyl group to the DNA, and basically on the cytosine basis of the 5-5th carbon lead to DNA methylation. Methyl group and epigenetic factor bound in some, actually from where methyl group comes from. Methyl group found in our some dietary sources can tag DNA and activate or express some genes. So it is epigenetic pathway. It is activate or express genes. Matlab, it leads to change in the expression of the genes or alter the expression of genes. Histones are proteins which are DNA can bind for compaction and gene regulation. Histone modification, the binding of epigenetic factors to histone tails alter the extent to which DNA is wrapped around the histones and the availability of the genes in the DNA to be activated. So health endpoints, the change in the epigenetic factor. The epigenetic factor can cause actually what is histone change, DNA accessible, gene active ho jayega. Then what are the changes which lead with our health endpoints, cancer, autoimmune disease, mental disorder and diabetes. So we will be give a short note about the DNA methylation. DNA methylation is an epigenetic mechanism. It is an epigenetic mechanism. Epigenetic matlab on the above of genes, genetic. That occurs by the addition of, how it's occur? It occurs by the addition of methyl group to the DNA. Methyl group to the DNA, thereby it can modify the function of genes and effective gene expression. So methyl group found in some dietary sources which add on the DNA and DNA methylation occur, therefore it often modifies the function of the genes and the affecting gene expression. The most widely characterized DNA methylation process is the covalent addition of the methyl group to the 5th carbon of the cytosine ring, resulting in the 5-methyl cytosine, also known as the 5th base of DNA. What happened? Methyl group is CH3 group. It add on the 5th carbon of the cytosine. So CC bond is carbon-carbon bond is covalent bond. So covalent bond form, and the name of the complex is the 5-methyl cytosine, also known as the 5th base DNA. These methyl groups project into major groove of DNA and inhibit transcription, and by deamination cytosine can be converted into thymine causing mutation. Actually, this methyl groups projecting major groove of DNA and it inhibit transcription. Actually, some genes are involved for transcription. Transcription is changing of DNA to RNA by deamination. Deamination cytosine can be converted into thymine, which causing mutation. You have to be see here the structure of cytosine and the 5th carbon, that is being carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th कार्बन पे मिथाइल ग्रुप ऐड हो जाएगा एंड इट लीड्स टू DNA. Here is the DNA regulatory proteins. These are the regulatory proteins you have to be seen in this photo. Regulatory proteins, this is a Tata box protein coding region, promoter region, and the DNA RNA polymerase enzyme. You have to be seen the double coiling portion of DNA. This is the double coiling portion of DNA and the promoter region in the left hand side and the protein crossing region on the right hand side. And some transcription factors from regulatory proteins are there, and the Tata box TATA, a specific repetition of the TATA, it is known as the Tata box, and the RNA polymerase which start transcription from 5' to 3', and the at one end it stops transcription. In human DNA, 5-methyl cytosine is found in approximately 1.5% of genomic DNA. In the total DNA, 5-methyl cytosine is found in 1.5%. In somatic cell, 5-methyl cytosine occur exclusively in the absence of paired symmetrical methylation of a CpG site. Methylation occur at the CpG site in single strand length greater than 200 base pair, GC percent more than 50%, in which a cytosine nucleotide is added next to the guanidine nucleotide. Firstly, cytosine is present in next from cytosine, guanine is present, and from cytosine on its 5-5th carbon methyl group is added, so that the length changes occur in somatic cells. We have known that the somatic cells 5-methyl cytosine occur exclusively in the context of paired symmetrical methylation sites of DNA length greater than 200 base pair, GC content more over 50%, in which cytosine nucleoside related next to the guanine nucleotide. In the bulk of genomic DNA, most CpG sites are heavily methylated. When there is so much DNA and there is so much GC content, then there is a highly chances of methylation in a germline tissues and located near promoters of normal somatic cells remain unmethylated, as allowing gene expression to occur. More than 60% of mammalian promoters have CpG islands. When a CpG island is a promoter region of a gene is methylated, the expression of gene is expressed, it is turned off. When any CG sites is methylated, then the expression of gene, which is this, is controlled. After addition of methyl group or methyl DNA, that expression is suppressed or turned off, or any expression is being overregulated. Our own theory of evolution of DNA methylation is that it evolved as a host defense mechanism. And why methyl group is added? Actually, it evolved a host defense mechanism. So what is the reason of DNA methylation? DNA methylation occur because of the suppression of or silence of the viral sequences, replicated transpose elements, and other repetitive sequences. So why DNA methylation occur? Actually, it is a favor reason, because DNA methylation silencing the foreign material, foreign DNA of what? The viral DNA, which is enter in the human body or in mammalian body, replicated transposable elements and other repetitive sequence, which is to be altered by the DNA methylation. But the DNA methylation also play important role in silencing the tissue specific genes to prevent them from being exposed to the wrong tissue. So DNA methylation is also play important role in silencing the tissue specific genes to prevent them from expressing in wrong region. Both genetic and epigenetic changes occur simultaneously in an organism. Genetic alteration include mutation. Mutation meaning the change in the DNA sequence that leads to mutation, like ATGC. On the change of GC, there is the coming of G also, then it is gene mutation. Deletion of that group, insertion of another group, and changes in copy number, that are the genetic changes. But what are the epigenetic alteration? Epigenetic alteration is addition of the methyl group, that is methylation. Histone and selected non-histone protein alteration. Non-coding RNA alteration, that is imprinting and chromatin remodeling, broadly include non-genetic alteration that are capable of being transferred from one cell to another. तो एपिजेनेटिक अल्ट्रेशन लाइक मिथाइलेशन, क्रोमेटिन रिमॉडलिंग एंड हिस्टोन इन सेलेक्टेड नॉन हिस्टोन प्रोटीन अल्टरनेशन, नॉन कोडिंग आरएनए अल्टरनेशन, इम्प्रिंटिंग, दे आर नॉन जेनेटिक अल्ट्रेशन. देयर इज नो इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ जीन्स एक्चुअली, बट दिस आर ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन सेल टू द अनदर, सो डेट एंड इट ऑल्सो चेंजेस द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ द जीन्स, सो इट ऑल्सो इन्फ्लुएंस अवर जीन्स इन अ पर्टिकुलर वे, सो इट इज़ नोन एज द एपिजेनेटिक चेंजेस. What is the chromatin remodeling? Chromatin remodeling is the enzyme-assisted process to facilitate chromatin remodeling. It is the enzyme-assisted process to facilitate access of nucleosomal DNA. By the remodeling the structure, composition, and position of nucleosomes. So, chromatin remodeling is the enzyme-assisted process to facilitate access of nucleosomal DNA. What is nucleosomal DNA? Nucleosomal DNA meaning nucleosome is the by formed by the DNA and histone protein contraction, because we know that the our a single cell contain the DNA of 2 meter length, that is so much long length, because DNA is an active charge. If we react the DNA with positive charge species like histone proteins like lysine and arginine rich amino acid, and it form a coiled like structures. It form a coil like structures in that way, and coiling occur, the reaction of nucleosome DNA plus histone proteins give rise to nucleosome, and the facilitate access of nucleosomal DNA by remodeling the structure. By remodeling the structure of nucleosome, composition and position of nucleosome, it is an epigenetic process. Chromatin remodeling is the dynamic modification of chromatin architecture to allow access of condensed genomic DNA to the regulatory transcription machinery proteins and thereby control gene expression. So how it control gene expression is the dynamic modification of chromatin architecture to allow access of condensed genomic DNA. जो condensed genomic DNA to regulatory transcription, that genomic condensed genomic DNA, it will control transcription and control gene expression. Why do cells require chromatin remodeling, and why the cells require chromatin remodeling? Binding of DNA to the histone octamer and the bending of the molecule on the protein surface present on a strong barrier to the sequence specific recognition of the nucleosomal DNA molecule. That's why packaging of DNA into nucleosome and higher orderly structure inhibitory to all kind of DNA dependent process. To overcome DNA accessibility problem, cells have developed mechanism to open higher order structures of chromatin and to disturb nucleosome, allowing the bending of nucleosome sequence specific regulators. And that's why packaging of DNA nucleosome and high order structure generally inhibitory to all kind of DNA dependent process. To overcome DNA sequence accessibility problem, cells have mechanism to open higher structures and chromatin to stop nucleosome along the binding of sequence specific regulators. Actually, we will learn types of chromatin remodeling in the next video, and we will do chromatin remodeling in detail in the next video. Thank you guys.